Hey guys, what's up and welcome to a new Tesla update video. So today, as usual, let's go over Tesla, let's go over the market, let's figure out what is happening and what we can expect moving forward. So as usual, if you enjoyed, don't forget to hit that like button. It does help a lot. This is not financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor. And my membership section on YouTube is live. The link is below if you're interested for $3 a month. I share my intraday thoughts on Tesla and whatnot as it moves throughout the day. But moving into Tesla, closing the day in the green slightly, actually, up about 1% on the day, which is putting us at almost $254 per share, which unfortunately, compared to the market, is a slight underperformance, but nothing completely crazy and out of the world. Just, you know, a little bit weaker than maybe it would have been, you know, we would have liked to see as a bull. Now, there's a few things to talk about. So the most important thing by far is the fact that, of course, Wednesday is earnings day. Very, very crucial. And it seems like the stock right now is pretty much setting up exactly for that, right? So with that being said, let's discuss this. So there's a few things to say here. So first and foremost, on the daily, we have a few important things, right? Number one, we're getting supported in this case by the 100-day moving average, which is this yellow line at the bottom, the thick yellow line, and the 50-day moving average, which is this orange line right beside it roughly, which is pretty much sitting at 250, 251, something along the lines of that. Unfortunately, the 100-day did cross the 50, which is usually a bearish crossover. When a higher like moving average crosses over a smaller moving average, it's usually a bit bearish. But I think it's a lot more scary if it's the 200 crossing something like the 50. That to me is a little bit scarier, honestly. But nonetheless, it's a little bit worrisome, right? It's not ideal, but at the bright side, we are bouncing off of them so far in the very, very low 250s. Now, with that being said, we are getting rejected by the 21 EMA, which is this kind of golden line at the top, which is, again, sitting at around almost $256 per share. So we're kind of sandwiched back in between these moving averages once again. Now, with that being said as well, there's another perspective to take a look at. So like I said, not too long ago, right, we kind of fell out of this blue line right here, right? We were standing in this little mini channel right here, short-term channel. We fell below it, right, and we had a decent fall, and we did enter the 240s ever so briefly, and it got bought up actually quite quickly this morning, right? I did say I think we'll enter the 240s. I still think we'll potentially come back into it. We'll see, of course, but I guess we technically did. It was a lot more short-lived than I expected though, right? It just got bought up within the first like 15 minutes of trading this morning. Now, with that being said, we did break below this blue line. Now, another valid perspective that still holds a very bullish perspective as well is going to be this. So we still have this blue line at the top, right, that acts as a resistance, right, all the way from pretty much previous earnings, actually, right, when we were at about almost $300 per share. We had a massive fall, and then we came back up close to around 280 per share, and then we got rejected, came back up again, this time close to 270 per share, got rejected, right? On the flip side, we have the low over here, right? This was the low of about $210. We got, you know, bounced off of that, came back down here as well, went down to about 234, 235, bounced off of there. And now we have these blue lines right here. So we're going to actually remove this one here because it's essentially pointless now. And we're going to be taking a look at this instead, right? These two new blue lines, this one, of course, being fairly parallel to the red line of this overall massive ascending channel, right? So the good thing about this is that this can easily be viewed as a massive bull pennant. For instance, if you were to take it, let's say, from roughly here, right, go like this, you have a massive pole of the actual bull pennant, right? Bull flag, bull pennant. It's honestly more or less the same thing. It just looks slightly different, but the idea is similar, right? And then you have, of course, a movement like this where it kind of gets tighter and tighter and tighter, right? And then, of course, as it gets tighter, which we're pretty much at the apex right now, we're extremely close to it, you obviously explode in a certain direction. And as if that's not fitting enough, we, of course, have the squeeze indicator, which is now showing us, you can see here, a fourth red circle in a row, right? Obviously indicating that this is indeed going to be some form of squeeze. Whether it's to the upside or to the downside is yet to be seen. We'll keep track of it. Right now, you can see, if you look closely, there's no bars like above or below being shown on the red circle. There's no like blue bar above. There's no kind of orange bar below it. Once we start seeing one of those start picking a direction, especially before the squeeze even happens, that usually gives you an idea that there's a pretty, you know, decent likelihood it's going to be in this direction. So for instance, if let's say we see another red circle tomorrow, but we start seeing a blue bar appear above that red circle tomorrow, that's a good sign for the bulls. On the flip side, if we start seeing another orange bar start appearing once again, that could be a good sign for the bears. So we'll, of course, keep track of it. But as of right now, it's neutral. It's like the market doesn't even know where Tesla wants to squeeze. And it probably doesn't, because earnings is right around the corner. That could be the catalyst we're waiting on. So with that being said, I personally wouldn't be surprised if nothing really happens tomorrow, and then maybe something happens Wednesday, maybe some leak happens, maybe someone knows some insider information, you know, the suits and all that. Sometimes they get insider information before, you know, people like us do, right? Could happen. We could see a bit of a move tomorrow, but more than likely we will see the move obviously pretty much as earnings happens, right, post market, and then probably Thursday as well. So I wouldn't be surprised if we're kind of just building up steam, building up momentum for that. Now, again, in order to kind of understand what, you know, the scenarios are, obviously we want to take a look at a few things. So let's talk about what the potential bearish situations are and what the bulls want to defend, right? So if we're going to be holding true to this blue line right here, we can still potentially come down to almost the mid 240s, like 245, 246, and still get a bounce off of this and consider it completely valid. And that's perfectly fine. Or we can even go a little bit lower to the very low 240s, like 240, 41, maybe 42, right? Depending on obviously when it happens. And then from there, obviously, as long as the bulls defend that and we don't fall out of this massive channel, could be great news as well. And that's looking pretty good for the bulls. And the bears, of course, want to do the exact opposite of what I just said. They want to break through those levels. Now, on the flip side, the bulls also want to go ahead and be breaking above the 21 EMA, number one. We just talked about that, right? 256 roughly, while the bears want to break the 150-day moving average, which is the very low 250s. But as if that's not enough, the bulls absolutely also want to go ahead and break pretty much above this situation right here we find ourselves in, right? Something like this. They really want to be breaking above this blue line right now, which is going to be putting us at somewhere around 265, maybe even close to 270, right? Kind of roughly where we got rejected here. But you can see it's obviously getting tighter. Like if I kind of squish it like this, you can see it's getting tighter and tighter and tighter, right? Right? We're bouncing less and less. That's how you know when something is getting tighter and it's really about to make a large move, because it's, you had a wide range of movement and it's getting tighter. And the range of movement is getting smaller and smaller as you're kind of ping-ponging in between this little pennant, right? That's obviously signifying that there's a lot of tension being built up. And once it gets to the apex, which we're very close to, that's where it unleashes to a direction. So those are the levels I'll be looking at right now. And obviously moving forward to see if one of these levels breaks, then that's probably the trajectory that we'll be going in for the next foreseeable future, few months at least, in my opinion. That's the way I'm looking at it right now. So take that for what it's worth, ladies and gentlemen. Now let's take a quick look at options flow. Unfortunately, there's not a whole lot to talk about, so we'll go ahead and open it up regardless, just for the sake of talking about it. But, you know, it's, I guess, slightly more bullish, definitely slightly more bullish than bearish. But, you know, none of these are major flows, right? We have like a almost 500K premium here. We have like almost a 500K premium here, which is a lot, obviously, but it's not like a massive whale. Nothing that I would personally be like, wow, okay, we should, like, you know, be paying attention to this. It's all very kind of, you know, mutes, honestly, nothing substantial, nothing really noteworthy of truly, truly mentioning and, you know, truly, truly following. So take that for what it's worth as well. Moving over to the weekly chart very quickly here, let's take out the squeeze indicator as well. And you can see on the weekly also showing us the exact same thing that the daily is showing us. Obviously, it's only three red circles, but each red circle is a full week. So even the weekly is showing that we're getting some sizable tension being built up right now for Tesla, which most likely, like I said, is going to get unleashed during, or I guess post earnings, or maybe even during earnings itself. Now, always look at the MACD. You can see the MACD also not really showing a direction. You can see, like, if we go back here, the MACD usually has some form of direction, right? You know, the bars get obviously bigger or smaller or whatever, but in a direction. But you can see recently over here on the right, no direction for like several weeks now. This is not even just a few. This is like many weeks in a row where it's not really showing a true direction. It is slowly getting larger to the downside. That red bar on this week is slowly getting larger, but it's nothing substantial just yet. And that could easily be still fixed, of course, based on how this week plays out. So the point is that there seems to be a lot of tension being built up and this next move could be pretty substantial. So we'll see. No one knows for sure where it's going to go. And if anyone does or act like they do, well, they're just lying, right? They don't actually know. But that's the main thing I'll be looking at right now. Ladies and gentlemen, there's not that much more to talk about. I don't think there'll be two crazy moves happening until probably Wednesday, at least, if not obviously Wednesday post-market or even Thursday itself for earnings. So other than that, we'll keep updating. We'll see if anything changes tomorrow, anything important that can maybe kind of give us a better idea and signify the direction that we might actually go, you know, during earnings. But as of right now, nothing substantial. And it's one of those scenarios where I'm personally playing it in a more reactionary way. And I'm set up for both positions. I have shares to the upside. But if we go back down to the downside and we get a bit of a crash, I have cash to buy as well. So I'm kind of, you know, putting myself in a situation where I feel like I'll win regardless. You know what I mean? And that's the way I like to play it. So with that being said, thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions, of course, leave it down below. But don't forget to hit that like button. And I'll see you tomorrow for the next update. Thank you for watching. Peace.